So today we begin with the chapter photosynthesis. Fine, so I'll tell you what we'll be doing in the chapter. I have changed the order of the chapter a little bit to suit your learning as well as my teaching. So we will first begin with understanding the definition of photosynthesis, and then we'll move on to the experiments for photosynthesis. All right, so today this is what we are going to do. And then tomorrow we will study in detail the structure of the chloroplast and how the light and dark reaction take place and what is the potassium ion theory. Fine, children? So just because today I see only 14 children logged in and I don't want y'all the others to miss on anything. So we'll start with the definition and the basic experiments. The experiments are familiar. We've already dealt with those before. Right? Just a quick recap. It is the process by which autotrophic organisms use light energy to make sugar and oxygen from carbon dioxide and water. It occurs in plants, algae, as well as some prokaryotes. It is anabolic, that is small molecules combined, and it stores energy. It is stored as carbohydrate in their bodies. Okay, so now this is the basic reaction for photosynthesis. I'll explain what I have read once again. Autotrophic means plants which make their own food. Autotrophic means self. Auto means self. So autotrophic organisms are those organisms which prepare their own food. So plants, in fact, green plants are autotrophic organisms which use the energy from the sun, the light energy from the sun, to prepare glucose and oxygen. And they do it from the raw materials, carbon dioxide and water, in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. Is this clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it occurs in plants, algae. Why algae? Because algae are green and they contain chlorophyll and some prokaryotes. Anabolic, now what is the meaning of anabolic? We have anabolic and we have catabolic. So anabolic because here smaller molecules combine to give a bigger molecule. So you see that in the preparation of glucose, you see many molecules coming together. It is a process in which when glucose is prepared, it is stored as starch in the plant body. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now it is an example of an endothermic reaction. So like you can see in the image here, first the water is absorbed from the roots and the light is taken by chlorophyll. Chlorophyll traps the sunlight to help in the preparation of food by the plants. This process occurs in the green parts of a plant. So most of it occurs in the leaves because leaves are predominantly places where you have chlorophyll, and also in green stem of the plant. The raw material hence is water and carbon dioxide. In the presence of light and chlorophyll, the plant is giving glucose, which is stored in the form of starch in the parts of the plant, whereas the oxygen is given out into the air. Now this oxygen is helpful for living beings. Hence photosynthesis is an example of an endothermic reaction. The chlorophyll and pigments in the plant absorb the energy from the sun's rays, and hence the endotherm, as an endothermic reaction, it is the reaction where energy is absorbed. Is this clear, children?
Yes.
Okay. Now, what is starch? Starch is the stored form of carbohydrate in the plants, and this starch turns iodine dark blue. So we need to remember that when we test for starch, the color change that we get is iodine turns dark blue.
Now, which page are we on?
I'm not teaching you from a book, child.
Okay.
Have you paid attention to what I have taken you through?
I'm looking for it. I thought it was somewhere in the book.
Please pay attention to the screen, children, especially when I'm sharing the screen. And when I'm teaching you from the book, I will let you know. However, I do have the scanned copies of the book as well when I teach you. So you just pay attention to your screen while I'm teaching. Fine? Okay. Can someone tell me the definition of photosynthesis from what we just studied? Please raise your hand. Are you able to hear me, Melissa?
Yes, ma'am.
You can't define photosynthesis?
It's right there on the screen.
Okay, you want me to hide that? Okay, now come on, define photosynthesis.
Ma'am, it is a process by which plants use carbon dioxide and water to form glucose, which is stored in the form of starch.
And
there's oxygen as a byproduct.
Okay, and in the presence of chlorophyll and?
Sunlight.
And please do not forget anything that is mentioned in the reaction. Okay, we also saw the balanced reaction for photosynthesis. So can someone tell me the reaction for photosynthesis in the form of a chemical equation? Yes, Aditya?
A 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives you C6H12O6 plus 6O2.
And what about the arrows?
Wait, what?
What do you write on the arrow?
On the arrow, sunlight.
And?
Chlorophyll.
Sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, the ones who have just joined the class, good morning, first of all. And you should be here logged in at sharp 9. Henceforth, at 9:05, I will stop any other person from joining in the class. Have I made myself clear, children? Yes? Okay. Now we will move on to the experiments for photosynthesis. So now this is from your book. So, but you all can still pay attention to the screen instead of looking into your books. You can deal with your books after the class is over. Now, the experiments of photosynthesis, there are a number of experiments, children, that can be performed. Okay. However, that is for proving various conditions which are necessary for photosynthesis. So, we know that for photosynthesis, chlorophyll is essential, light energy is essential, right? Carbon dioxide is essential as a raw material. Fine. So all these need all the even water is essential for that matter for photosynthesis to occur. So each condition can be tested. Okay. Now, first you need to understand what you mean by destarching, which is the removal of starch. A plant is used for experiments on photosynthesis. So a plant which is used for experiments for photosynthesis, it should be placed in the dark. That is away from sunlight for 24 to 48 hours. Why is this done? This is done to destarch the leaves. So if your plant is kept for 24 to 48 hours in darkness, the plant is not performing photosynthesis. Hence, starch is not being produced. So this is the first step towards destarching the leaves. Now, a destarched plant is one whose leaves are free from starch. So, in the experiments that we discuss further, we will need leaves which are free from starch. A plant is destarched by placing it in dark, I've already told you this, for 24 to 48 hours. Now, after we destarch the leaf, have you understood how we destarch a leaf, children? It's very simple. Shravani, can you tell me how we can destarch a leaf?
Ma'am, by placing a plant in dark for 24 to 48 hours.
So what will happen if it is placed in darkness?
Ma'am, so it will not get sunlight and it will not photosynthesize.
As a result, starch will not be present in the leaf. Now we have to prove that starch is not present in the leaf. So how do we test for iodine? Okay, so this is now to test a leaf for starch using iodine. The first step, children, is boiling the leaf in water for 1 minute to kill the cells. Can you all put yourself on mute, children, to avoid disturbance? Okay. So you boil the leaf for 1 minute to kill all the cells. Then boil the leaf in methylated spirit over a water bath till it becomes pale white due to, so this is how it looks, okay, due to the removal of chlorophyll. So what do you do first? You first boil it in water. After that, you remove it from water and you will place, you will boil it in methylated spirit. Are you able to hear me? Show me a thumbs up. Okay. So you boil it in methylated spirit in this manner. Water bath is this. Can you see this beaker with boiling water placed over a flame? And you see a test tube with methylated spirit and the leaf which was previously boiled is put into it. Now this process is done for the removal of the pigment chlorophyll. So when you boil the leaf in such a manner, the leaf will become hard and brittle. What is the meaning of brittle? That you can, when you take the leaf and press it between your fingers, it will turn to powder. You know, it will become brittle, breakable. So now we want to make the brittle leaf soft again. So what do? You immediately remove it and you place it in hot water. And this will soften the leaf. After that, you will carefully spread the leaf in a petri dish. And you will pour iodine solution on it. So we have something that is iodine and we have iodine solution. Okay. So you put iodine solution on it. The presence of starch will be indicated by blue-black. What we said, it is very dark blue. So that is blue-black. This color is very important. Remember, blue-black color. A leaf without starch will show brown coloration. So if we are doing this test and pouring iodine solution over it, we will find that if the color of the leaf turns blue-black, that means the starch is present in the leaf. A leaf without starch will show brown color. Is this clear, children? So what was the first step towards removal of chlorophyll? I mean, towards the testing the leaf for starch. What do? To a de-starch leaf.
Putting the leaf in boiled water.
Okay, for how long?
For 1 minute.
After that, what do? Akshar?
We boil the leaf in methyl spirit.
Okay, you will boil the leaf in methylated spirit in a water bath. Okay. Aditya, what do? Yes. What color does the leaf become after boiling it in methylated spirit?
Blue-black.
After methylated spirit, it becomes blue-black directly. You're missing something.
Colorless or something, I don't know.
Hard and brittle.
Mm-hmm. Pale white.
Who says pale white? Give me your name.
Kanchan.
Kanchan, yes, she's paying attention to the screen.
Pale white.
Yes, Aditya, I've told you to pay attention to the screen. Okay, it becomes pale white due to the removal of chlorophyll. Okay, and after that, the leaf also becomes hard and brittle. You will place this leaf in hot water and it will soften the leaf. After it becomes soft, that is after you remove it from the hot water and place it in a petri dish, only then will you pour iodine over it.
Iodine solution.
And then you will see that if starch was present. Now we took a de-starched leaf in this case. So what do you think the color will be?
Brown.
It will show brown color. Had we taken a leaf which was not de-starched, which went through the process of photosynthesis and starch was produced, then you will find that the leaf turns blue-black in color. Now let's go on to the first experiment. So the first experiment is to show that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. So you will take a plant with variegated leaves. Now, what is the meaning of variegated? This is a variegated leaf. Okay? A leaf which you've seen leaves which are not completely green in color, right? In nature, you have all kinds of leaves, all shapes, sizes, and colors. Now, this particular leaf does not have only green color. Croton is one variety where, you know, you find green as well as maroon colors of the leaf. Then you have leaves which are green and yellow in color. Do you remember seeing leaves like this? If no, y'all should be more observant when you take a walk in nature. Okay? So, this is how the leaf looks when you take a leaf. Now, what do you do to this leaf? You will first see, these are the examples. Okay? For a variegated leaf. You will destarch the leaf first by keeping the whole plant in a dark room. So your experiment starts by destarching the leaf. Can someone tell me why we are destarching the leaf when we want to test for chlorophyll?
So that no photosynthesis occurs, maybe.
Yes, so that no photosynthesis occurs and we want to test for chlorophyll. So we want to prove that when chlorophyll is not there, then the plant will not be able to prepare starch, right? If you take a leaf which has already got starch in it, then the starch already present in the leaf will not help us prove that the starch was prepared only after the conditions were provided. Is that clear, children? So first, yes, you have to start with a plant which has no starch at all. Then after that, you will place the plant in the sun. So when you place the plant in the sun, now you'll be able to prove that only under the experimental conditions did the plant prepare starch and photosynthesis occurred. Fine. So then you place the destarched plant in the sunlight. After a few hours, you will pluck one of the leaves and you will make an outline on paper and mark the green and the non-green areas, because later we are going to compare. After that, we will test the leaf for starch. So how do you test the leaf for starch? You do the process which we have already studied about. So what do? You first boil it in water, then you boil it in methylated spirit in a water bath, and then you will remove the leaf and put it in hot water so that it becomes soft. Then you spread it on a petri dish and you pour iodine solution over it. So when this is test the leaf for starch, you that entire process which was studied right in the beginning. Okay, when you test for starch, what do you find? That only the green parts of the leaf turn blue black. Can you see the result that you will get? You will get that the green part of the leaf turns blue black, whereas the remaining portion, the yellow portion of the leaf, will remain brown. Okay, so the blue black indicates that the green part of the leaf prepared starch during photosynthesis, whereas the non-green part of the leaf did not prepare starch during the process of photosynthesis. So green indicates chlorophyll. So only the part of the leaf which contained chlorophyll could prepare the starch, whereas the part which did not contain chlorophyll did not prepare starch. Hence proved that chlorophyll is essential for preparation of starch. That means chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. Is this clear, children?
Yes.
Let me see a thumbs up. Okay. Fine. So this is how the result would look. Only the green parts of the leaf give the iodine test for the presence of starch, proving that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. Okay. Now the second experiment is to show that sunlight is necessary for photosynthesis. So again, you will take destarched leaves, means you will pluck leaves from a plant which is kept in the darkness for 24 to 48 hours. After taking a destarched leaf, we will cover one of its leaves with a black paper in this fashion. Okay, can you see this? You can make any shape that you like. They've decided to make a star, and you will clip this black paper very neatly and securely to the green leaf. Okay. What do you do after that? You will place this plant again in the sun. So right now when you're placing it in the sun, the entire leaf does not contain starch. Now after placing it in sunlight, photosynthesis is going to occur. This is what we are assuming, right? Now after placing it in the sunlight, when photosynthesis occurs, you will find at the end of the experiment, after a few hours, when you do the iodine test, that the part of the plant which was green in color and which was also able to get sunlight turns blue black, whereas the plant which the part of the leaf which was covered by the black paper does not turn blue black, it remains brownish in color. Hence proved that light along with chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. Right? Yes, children. Now the part of the plant which is hidden by the black paper also has chlorophyll, right? But it is not getting sunlight. So which is that one condition which is absent in this experiment? Sunlight. Fine. So hence we have tested for sunlight. The part of the plant which is only exposed to sunlight will give the positive result for the iodine test, that the part will turn blue black, whereas the part which was not visible to sunlight will not give a positive result. Hence proved that light is essential for photosynthesis. The third experiment is to show that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. So again, you will begin with destarched leaves. Okay, how will you start with destarched leaves? Narayan, can you tell me how we destarched the leaves?
Caught me at the right time. Okay.
Were you sleeping with your eyes open?
Sort of. I have to wake up even earlier now. Is this the one where you boil it?
We know it is 3 o'clock in the morning where you are.
No, it's earlier.
Oh, what's the time there?
Wait one second. Wait, it's, oh, well, I woke up earlier. Now it's 12.
Leave it. It's 12.
Is, no, but for me, it's really bad.
Okay, I can understand. You should rest during the day, Narayan, if you have to take your classes through the night. Otherwise, it will cost you your health. And you need to really sleep well, right? Especially during these days to retain on your immunity. Isn't it? I hope all the others are taking a good sleep of 7 to 8 hours and not more.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, too much sleep is also not good for your health. Okay?
Ma'am Narayan has become nocturnal.
Yeah, I am nocturnal.
Yes, he's become nocturnal so that he attends his grade 10 classes till he's back in India, right? Okay.
This is the one where you boil it in that in a water bath with methane.
No, we have not reached that. We have still we are talking about destarching. Yes.
First you leave it in the dark for 24 to 48 hours. Am I right?
Right. So that's what we do, first destarching the leaves. After that, we will insert a part of its leaves through a split cork into a conical flask containing potassium hydroxide. So right now we are studying how to prove that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. So we will insert half a leaf through a split cork into a conical flask. So this is how the apparatus would look. Okay, can you see the apparatus? So this is a conical flask. You have put half a leaf into this conical flask where you have potassium hydroxide. So what does the potassium hydroxide do? It absorbs the carbon dioxide, right? So now this environment is carbon dioxide free. And then you place the plant in the sun. After you place the plant in the sun, the leaf that you pluck from this plant, now this plant is, the leaf is intact with the plant, okay? And you are putting this conical flask in this fashion. You remove the leaf and then you test for starch. What will you observe? That the part of the leaf which was inside the conical flask, which did not receive carbon dioxide, okay, did not test positive for starch. So it did not turn blue-black. Whereas the part of the leaf which was available to sunlight as well as carbon dioxide received all the necessary conditions for photosynthesis, it turned blue-black, hence proved that carbon dioxide is also necessary for photosynthesis. Is this clear, children?
Yes.
Yes, I think it's not that difficult. And the last experiment for the day is to presents to check the presence of oxygen. Okay, so that oxygen is produced during photosynthesis. So what do? We place some water plants. So we either take Elodia or we take Hydrilla and we take it in a beaker containing some pond water and cover it with a short-stemmed funnel. So this is how the setup would look. Now, this is a very, very important board point of view, especially this experiment. Please see the setup. So we have an inverted funnel. We have placed some hydrilla water plants here and we've taken pond water in a beaker. And this support here is very important. Can you see the support to keep the funnel off the bottom? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
This support is very important. So you need to draw this in the exam if ever you get to draw this diagram. This support is important. Then you have the plant here. Okay. Now what happens when you place this plant in pond water and you place it in sunlight? The plant will perform photosynthesis. Okay. When the plant is performing photosynthesis, it gives out a particular gas. Carbon dioxide, it is taking in the dissolved form from the water. The oxygen which is produced will move up because it is less dense and it will collect in this portion. Can you see the arrow, the mouse? Okay, yeah. Okay. So you see that the oxygen gas is lighter. It collects in this portion of the test tube. Okay, and you can see bubbles. Now in this experiment, two things are very important. One is the support to keep the funnel off the bottom so that you have the water going in, the carbon dioxide going in and the oxygen rising. Okay, so that the experiment is successful. And you, the other important thing is sunlight. If you forget to draw the sunlight in your examination, your entire experiment will be marked wrong. So in every experiment for photosynthesis, sunlight is very, very important to draw. Okay. Fine. So you've seen the setup. So the gas in the test tube. Now, how do you test for the gas? You will take it close after you remove the test tube. You will test the gas with a glowing splinter, which bursts into flame. Oxygen supports combustion. We all know this, right? So the moment you take the a glowing splinter to the mouth of the test tube, it will burst into a flame, which means that there was presence of oxygen, which came in contact with the glowing splinter. So a you have to remember this, these words. A glowing splinter bursts into a flame. Exactly in this manner. Okay. And this proves that oxygen gas was released during the process of photosynthesis. Clear, children?
Yes.
Have we understood this experiment? In fact, all the others?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So we have seen four experiments today. Can someone tell me which four experiments we have done today? Okay, we began with testing for
chlorophyll.
Starch.
Starch. We began with testing for starch. Okay, so we did the iodine test. That was the prerequisite. I mean, that is what was common for most experiments. So that was shown to you right in the beginning. Then we tested for number one, we tested for chlorophyll. Sorry, before that, we have tested for. Yes, we have first tested for chlorophyll. Then we where we took variegated leaves. Then we tested for sunlight, where we take a black paper. and wrap it around one of its leaves and test for starch. Then we test it for carbon dioxide, where we use a conical flask with potassium hydroxide. And last but most important and not the least at all, we tested for the product oxygen, which is given out during photosynthesis. And this is how the apparatus would look. Was today's class fine? Did you all understand, children, everything?
Yes,
I want
ma'am.
You all to revise these experiments once. So this is all we have for today. Okay. There's less than a minute left for the class to get over. If you all have any questions, children, with respect to the experiments, I'm sure you'll have a few when you start learning them from your book.